Hey Capricorns! As the thumbnail suggests, this reading isn't for everybody. The cards are a little bit racy, so if you're easily offended, please click off now. I don't want to offend anybody. I just want to give you guys a variety of readings. Okay, so if you're new, welcome. Please remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get my messages that I post. If you already know me, welcome back, my soul family. And as always, I'll leave information about what decks of cards I use in the description box, along with how to contact me for personal readings. And if you do want a reading featuring these cards or any of my other ones, just make a note of it when you email me. Okay, guys, so let's see what we have going on. Ooh, Ten of Pentacles. So we have Ten of Pentacles, Knight of Swords, the Hierophant there, and the Two of Wands jumping out first. So it's like you're at a crossroads, having overcome a divine lesson here, the Hierophant. You was taught something, probably relationship-wise, learned a few lessons, standing in your truth with the Knight of Swords, right? Standing in your power, really coming into yourself and owning your body here. So I feel like you're ready. You're at this crossroads. You're ready to open up to somebody to come into your life, to build with somebody now with the Ten of Pentacles. You're ready for the next chapter here. So next lesson, right? And let that lesson be in abundance. Okay, so you're at a crossroads. So you decide. The divine's here supporting you, with you. Somebody does want to rush their way into you here. Let's see. Major changes, okay? So your current standing will be coming to an end with the Ten of Pentacles. So if you are single, that's going to be coming to an end. And this is why there's a soulmate here rushing towards you. Maybe somebody younger, with it being a knight there. But they want a lot of action anyway. Let's see. The Wheel. Okay, so this is things turning around, like I said. No longer being single, as we can see here. I feel like somebody might be online dating with the Knight of Swords, because this is communication. So you could already be flirting with the idea of online dating, or somebody online already. Seems like the wheels are in motion for your soulmate here to come in towards you. So let's see. Empress, yeah, you are pulling them in with your sex appeal here. It is just overwhelming. And that's because you're in your own power now, right? After you've overcome this lesson with the divine here, you are standing in your power and you're in this Empress energy. And people just can't help but notice. Two major arcana there, one after another. So this is like somebody drawn towards you, just like they can't help it here. The Lovers. Okay, so good. You'll enjoy this relationship. It is a divine lover here. Somebody who's like, you know, meant to be with you. Cupid is pulling back his arrows. Actually, Libra, I think they just meet somebody as well. So maybe check out that reading. Could be a Gemini. We also have the Empress here and Taurus. most signs do generally come out in a reading, so I'm not really focused on that. But here I feel like this is a beautiful beginning. A beautiful start to this romance here. Somebody can't take their eyes off you. And like I said, you're an Empress. Very powerful here. You might have started feeling good during Aries season and the momentum is just going with you here. It can be that this person comes in Gemini season with the Knight of Swords and the Lovers. But the thing is, they're looking to build something long-term with the Ten of Pentacles. So it's your choice, of course, with the Two of Wands here. It's right at the beginning. You decide, are you ready for this soulmate? Do you want them? Because here they come. The star, look at that, it's time. It's destined to happen here. You've been through this healing. You've ascended here. You're this Empress energy. And that's why everything is just attracted to you. It may seem like your wishes are coming true because you're just amazingly what some people would call lucky at this time. It seems like everything going your way, the wheel, the Empress, the lovers, everything you desire here being yours. Anything you focus on comes to you here. Money, Ten of Pentacles, love, the lovers. Everything going in your favor now. Like, it's just like you decide where do you want to put your focus. That's what will come in first. So if you choose to focus on money first, the divine is here saying that's okay. I feel like although it's supposed to be a sensual reading, you know, that's important, but not as important as, you know, love to you right now. So I feel, you know, you have a freaky side with this Knight of Swords, but what's important is the love behind it, right? And if people come in and they are very passionate and find you attractive because you're giving off this Empress energy, it doesn't mean they're only after one thing. So maybe don't turn them down. This knight coming towards you is very trustworthy, loyal. He's telling the truth when they say, look, I want to be with you and I want it long term. They're telling the truth here. And it may sound like, well, you know, I wish for this and now it's actually here. I can't believe it because it's taken so long. But you better believe that that star and the divine there is guiding this person towards you now. Like I said, you could already have started to talk to them online or just flirted with the idea. The Fool. The universe will catch you if you jump. Take the chance to love. It's all part of the healing process. Once where it's like when we've been taught to swim and, you know, we say, go on then, go try it. We have to, you know, eventually jump and go by ourselves, right? Or the same as riding a bike. Stabilizers have got to come off here. You'll be supported. It's just that at times it feels like, you know, a little bit scary. Well, maybe I've heard so many horror stories about people online. So you hold yourself back. You're just missing out. 29% of people who meet online actually end up married. And this is what I'm seeing here. The Hierophant is a marriage card. The Star is a destiny card. So I'm seeing, and the Lovers, it's like it's meant to be. You've just got to take the chance and trust this person who's coming towards you. Look at this. Look at this. We have the Hierophant, the Wheel, the Empress, the Lovers, the Star, the Fool, and now the Sun. And the Sun is shining on the Sun card. This is positivity, clarity, healing, awakening. They awaken part of your soul and your body that you thought, you know, would never be touched again or woken up again. You know, and now all of a sudden you're abundant. It works like that with the Wheel, right? One day you could be down, but when you're down, the only way is up. After winter must come spring.